that's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Yeah, suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know, yeah. Who am I? Someone that's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Yeah.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Arlie, and I'm here with another video. We're checking out Game Theory. Will the meteor, Fortnite meteor, destroy everything? Here we go. Okay.
Hello, Internet. Welcome to Game Theory and the middle of Battle Royale Week. In case you missed the first of these special episodes, a few days ago I covered mathematical evidence against the media's claims that games like Fortnite and PUBG cause players to become more violent. And later this week, I'll be looking deeper at whether these games help your overall social skills. But today, I'm gonna examine a much more pressing issue. The meteor that's about to strike Tilted Towers tomorrow, turning this iconic area of the game map into nothing more than rubble. I'm not here to theorize about its
Is it true? Is it really gonna blow up Tilted Towers?
Or when and where it's gonna land. I think everyone who's been following that situation has a pretty good handle on that one already. Nope, I'm here today to explore how much destruction a meteor of that size traveling that fast should cause. Is this flying hunk of rock spelling Armageddon for the Fortnite map as we know it? Is Tilted Towers the only thing that's gonna be affected? Or should players expect to see the map become one giant crater? A bit of space science, chemistry, and physics have the answer. And I gotta say, this is a conclusion that I was not expecting. Now, to make sure that we're all on the same page, over the past month, Fortnite players have noticed that an unusual object has appeared in the sky. First, it was small and barely distinguishable from the surrounding stars. But each day, this unidentified flying object has grown larger and larger, causing an onslaught of speculation with the all but confirmed theory being that this thing is a meteor that's growing larger as it travels closer and closer to the Fortnite island. And if we're being specific, right now, this thing would technically be classified as a comet, as evidenced by its blue color and distinctive tail. When it officially enters the Fortnite planet's atmosphere, though, that's when it switches over and becomes classified as a meteor. Fun facts. Anyway, over the past few weeks, telescopes have begun to appear at various locations around the map, including Fatal Fields and Pleasant Park. That's right, all of these telescopes point directly at the comet. Additionally, over the past couple weeks, players have reported that their controllers vibrate at random times in seemingly random sequences. However, these vibrations are far from random, happening at very specific locations in the map at very specific times. The vibrations actually seem to be hidden messages written in Morse code. When translated, that message reads SOS D5418. The letters SOS are pretty obvious here, right? They're the typical call when you're...
Controller vibrations got Morse code in it? What the fuck? That's crazy.
Hell, fun fact, most people assume that SOS stands for Save Our Souls or Save Our Ship, but actually it doesn't stand for anything. It's just kind of a remnant from the earliest days of Morse code when ships needed to send out a distress call. The letters were actually meaningless. There you go. Anyway, the SOS part of this message is easy. We all know that. The next part of the message, D5, most likely corresponds to a location on the Fortnite map. On the game map, D5 is the location of Tilted Towers.
What?
And lastly, the final three digits correspond to the date 4/18, April 18th. The 18th of April is when Season 3 of Fortnite is slated to end. So, in short, between the added telescopes and in-game Morse code, I am confident that Tilted Towers will become some new location, something along the lines of Cavernous Crater. The developers at Epic Games are planning on altering the map of Fortnite in the easiest way that they know how. Chuck in a giant space rock at its most popular and most divisive location during the transition between seasons of the game. In one massive act of God, Epic Games is about to kill two birds with one meteor, all while creating a whole lot of hype in the process. But like I said, this is a theory that most Fortniters know already. What I want to explore is how deadly this meteor is gonna be. It seems like a pretty massive move to remove a few buildings from one grid on the map. And I've watched enough space movies to know that big meteors in the sky tend to yield big changes. to humanity's survival on a planet. So could there be a bigger change in store than just Tilted Towers' destruction? Let's see if you should spend your last hours of the season rocket riding your way to safety or preaching that the end is near. The Game Theorists, predicting fictional apocalypses since 2013. First, I want to determine the mass of the meteor. Real-life comets and meteors have varying densities based on the types of rocks that they're made from, ranging from 2 grams per cubic centimeter all the way to 8
this
grams.
This dude is deep. Matt Pat is deep, man.
Centimeter. So examining the characteristics of the meteor in Fortnite should help us find that density. Now, you might be thinking that it would be impossible to determine what this fictional video game comet would be made out of, but then you would just be underestimating our research powers. Comets and meteors have tails because their particles are ionized when exposed to solar wind. And wouldn't you know it, but the color on the tail corresponds to the material that the object is made from. Red corresponds to nitrogen, yellow corresponds to iron, and blue corresponds to magnesium. In Fortnite, the meteor very clearly has a blue tail, indicating that its chemical composition is magnesium-based. And, as such, we can use research to find that magnesium-based asteroids have a density of 3.32 grams per cubic centimeter. From there, all we need is volume, and, courtesy of our all-time favorite equation, D equals M over V, or in this case, M equals D times V, mass equals density times volume, we'll be able to figure out our mass. So, onward to volume. Now, some data miners have gone through the game's code and found a 3D model that strongly resembles a comet. Could this be what the comet will look like after the collision? We can't know for sure, but even if we were 100% confident, it doesn't help us out too much since there's nothing to give us a sense of scale here. Because we have nothing to measure this thing against, it could be anywhere from 5 centimeters to 5 kilometers wide. But luckily, a Reddit user reported seeing this 3D model located in the game. By exploiting the new replay functionality, user Dark Smudgy was able to look under Tilted Towers.
Wait, there is a replay functionality? No way.
Same model located there. Not only does that seem to confirm that this is in fact the meteor post-crash, because the towers are included in the image, we now have ourselves a reliable reference scale to base the size of this thing off of. Last video I was able to calculate the size of each square in-game to be 330 meters long using the measurements of this grounded battle bus. Applying this same scale to the model of the crashed meteor, it measures out to be just over 20 meters long, 12 meters high, and 4.8 meters wide. Just to give you some context, 20 meters long as a bowling alley, and 12 meters high is about as tall as a telephone pole. Using the formula to calculate the volume of an ellipsoid, b equals 4/3 times pi times a times b times c, the volume is calculated out to be 603 cubic meters, which we can now plug back into mass. The 603 million cubic centimeter meteor times the 3.32 grams per cubic centimeter density of a magnesium-based asteroid gives us a rock with mass slightly over 200,000 grams. When I say it like that, 200.
This dude went deep on me.
In kilograms, that sounds like a lot, but when it comes to the size of space rocks, it's actually not that heavy. It's only about as heavy as a jumbo jet, or just under as heavy
as the Tilted Towers is going to be crashing too as season 3 is about to end. That's interesting.
Statue of Liberty.
I'm definitely gonna give me a battle pass.
But even still, that is a 200 metric ton of space rock heading straight for the most popular location in the entire game. So now that we know the size and mass of the comet, let's actually find out its speed. Since the meteor appears to be getting closer every day, if we find the distance to it on each day, we can actually find the speed by dividing the distance that the comet has traveled by the time. In astronomy, scientists would use a technique called parallax, where they use angles calculated at various points around the globe to find the distance from view of the object. However, this just isn't possible in Fortnite, because the angle doesn't change based on where you're located on the map. I'm sure the programmers never intended anyone to give the angle to the comet a second thought. But I, dear viewers, I am that second thought. The other strategy here is to find the angular radius of the comet, and then use trigonometry to find the distance. And unbelievably, we can actually do this using the game's in-game compass.
That's crazy.
Mario Odyssey. I found that the meteor began with an angular radius of 0.184 degrees, and 10 days later had an angular radius of 0.8 degrees. And yeah, to eliminate all possible variables, these calculations were taken from the exact same location on the map at the exact same time of day. So the only difference here is the size of the meteor. Lastly, to find the distance to that meteor, we need to know the width of the meteor as it's flying through space. I mean, sure, we just calculated the width of the meteor when it was in the ground, but obviously this isn't the same size of the meteor when it's up flying in the sky. A substantial portion of meteors just break off as they enter the atmosphere in a process called fragmentation. Although the exact amount of fragmentation depends on variables such as
damn,
the surface area,
dude, it's really
atmosphere, meteors Players generally experience a fragmentation rate of about 50 to 60%. This means, upon entering into the atmosphere, a meteor like this would lose 50 to 60% of its mass. So if the mass of the meteor in the ground is 200 metric tons, then it would be expected to have a mass of about 400 metric tons while it's traveling through space. Doing the reverse of all the volume calculations we just did, a similarly proportioned ellipsoid prior to falling through the atmosphere would average out to be about 25 meters long. And with that number, we have every variable that we need to calculate the distance. Using a tangent function, which you might remember is the TOA part of SOHCAHTOA, tangent equals opposite over adjacent, we find that the meteor is going to be 15.5 kilometers away on day 1 and 3.5 kilometers away on the 10th day. It took that meteor 10 days, or 864,000 seconds, to move 12,000 meters, calculating a velocity of 0.013 meters per second. And if I had said it this way,
0.013 meters per second,
you would assume that that meant it was really fast. But I said it this way, which should lead you to believe that that is extremely slow. And it is. But to let you know how slow this thing is, to put it in perspective, a sloth, one of the slowest animals on the planet, has a top speed of 0.08 meters per second. That sloth is almost 6 times faster than the Fortnite meteor. By the way, with a speed of 0.013 meters per second and a distance of 3.5 kilometers away from the planet, the meteor still should have hit around April 13th. Anyway, that's beside the point. Here's the big question. With speeds that slow and a size as large as it is this meteor actually still dangerous? Kinetic energy is calculated using the formula 0.5 times mass times velocity squared. With a mass of 200 tons and a speed of 0.013 meters per second, kinetic energy calculates out to be 19 joules. 19 joules is the energy of an average person jumping. Believe it or not, but the meteor is simply traveling too slow to actually pose any threat to the Fortnite map. And that's no exaggeration. Using an online calculator from Purdue University, a 20-meter-long meteor with a density of 3.32 grams per cubic centimeter traveling at a speed of 0.013 meters per second would create a crater of only 1.6 meters wide and only 30 centimeters deep. That is the equivalent of dropping a pickup truck from, like, a few dozen feet up. I mean, sure, there might be a few cracks in the pavement, but no actual damage would take place. This meteor, based on all of its scientifically confirmed stats, would practically bounce off tilted towers. The most inconvenience that this thing would cause would just be that there's now a giant space boulder in the middle of the battlefield. So, all things being said, what's gonna happen on 4/18? Maybe Epic Games is just messing with all the players, and none of the evidence means anything. Most likely, players are gonna log into the game and find out that the site formerly known as Tilted Towers became ground zero for this massive meteor strike, and that'll be it. The rest of the map will just be 100% intact. But if the meteor behaved according to the science, it would land in the middle of Tilted Towers and literally not cause any damage whatsoever. Talk about a kick in the ass, Steroid. But hey, that's just a theory. A game theory. Thanks for watching. Make sure...
Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed that Game Theory episode. Make sure you subscribe for more, and peace. It's just interesting to see that a lot of the Fortnite has gotten this far. It's crazy. It's just crazy. Hey guys, make sure you purchase the MerchWise Hot Boy, and make sure you click the link in the description, man. What are you waiting for? Make sure you turn on post notifications, subscribe, and check out the latest videos and my music and the merch link and other stuff. I will see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for the support.